Hi everyone, it's Rosemary, your Afropean girl next door. If you're new to my channel, I just share information about personal development, personal growth, motherhood, and all the juicy things I'm working on. So today I'd like to talk to you about the myths around delivery. I did a video about pregnancy. As maybe some of you may know, I am heavily pregnant, and actually as I'm doing this video, I could be having the baby any day, but don't worry, I'm not gonna have the baby right now. I'm due in 2 days, but baby has decided to still stay in and comfortable. So hopefully, you know, I think by the time you watch this video, I would have had the baby, I think. All right, so I want to talk about some of the myths around delivery. And if you know you're out there and you're pregnant and you're scared about delivery and you're not sure how you can prepare for it, or you have a partner that is pregnant or a friend or a sister or whatever, and you want to maybe help them a little bit, I wanted to share some tips about that. I am a mother of two, I'm soon to be a mother of three, so I know a little bit about pregnancy and delivery, and I'm all about trying things that are natural as possible. So I've had two babies so far, and I was able to have two deliveries without complications, meaning no cesarean, so natural birth, and also no need to take any pain medication, so no epidural, no whatever, and no tears, no cuts, no nothing, and was able to do pretty well and recover pretty fast after delivery as well. And the reason why I'm telling you this is not to boast or anything, but because this is not always how things happen. For lots of women, delivery can be quite a traumatic experience, and for them, but also their partners, being there because you're not sure what to do and you don't really feel like you're in control of the situation. And a lot of women go into this thinking, okay, I don't know what to do, and you just leave it all up to the health experts. But there are a few things that you could do to help you plan. So one of the things that people think is that, first of all, delivery is like a clinical thing, like you have to be in a hospital setting, completely sanitized and all of that, and you have lots of doctors around you. At least when you watch movies, it seems like it's a very clinical procedure, if I could use that term. And I'm not saying that having a baby is, walk through the park or anything. What I'm saying is that, for instance, I live in Belgium currently, and most people here have a baby in the hospital. But our next door neighbor, so the Netherlands, a lot of women have home births there, which is very different. But it's just a neighboring country. And so I'm just trying to explain that people think that having a baby means you have to go to the hospital and do it in a very clinical setting, but there's different ways of having a baby, different places. You know, you could have your baby at home, you could also have your baby in birthing centers, which is a combination, I would say, of both, or in the hospital. And what is interesting to know is that as a woman, you have a choice. And a lot of women don't know that they have the choice to decide where they want to have their baby. We just assume that the only place to have a baby is in the hospital, at least as a choice. I'm saying for those, when the baby comes on time and everything is correct and you don't need any, you don't have any health issues, you could have your baby elsewhere. Myth number two is that your water breaks, and that's the first sign of labor. The reason why I think it's a myth is because, first of all, not every woman's water breaks. I can say for myself, my water did not break twice already. So that happened during the delivery. They had to actually burst a bubble themselves, if I may. Sorry for the explicits. But it doesn't happen. So if you're thinking that's going to be my first sign, then you could be waiting for a very long time, because it might not happen. And also, it might not happen the way that you've seen it in movies. So it's not like a big balloon burst and then there's water everywhere and you're peeing all over the place. It happens in trickles, and it could happen, you know, in the middle of the night or little by little. But it's very important that when it does happen, that you start preparing to go to the hospital, because when it completely runs dry, you could be having infections and it's not safe for the baby. So that's myth number two. Myth number three is that every woman needs to have a pain medication. That is also a myth, because when I spoke with lots of friends, everyone was kind of surprised. Oh, you didn't have pain medication? Like it's not normal or something. But there are ways that you can prepare your body so you don't need that. And I'm not saying that if you do need it, it's a problem, but there are, there are things that come with it. You could have complications and sometimes it doesn't work. I'm talking about the epidural to be specific. So what I do is before I'm actually full term, around between week 35 and 37, and I waited this time to start at week 37, I start taking something called red raspberry leaf tea. And so I drink about a cup a day, and I bump it up to drink a couple of cups a day, the closer I get to the due date. And this is to help you prepare your uterus for the contractions, for the delivery, so to tonify everything, to make sure you're in good shape. And also, to be in good shape means to work out and do all the extra things that you could do to prepare your body for this marathon, because it's definitely gonna be a marathon. And so there are ways that you can prepare. Taking a warm bath helps. I always sat in a bathtub at the hospital before I had the baby, and that really helps to control the pain. You could also have a water birth, which is, can be beneficial for you, but also for the baby. Unfortunately, not all hospitals have this. And also what you could be doing is figure out what other pain relief things could help you. For me, what helped a lot is pressure on the pain. So where I'm feeling pain during contractions, my husband would press. And for me, most of it was in my lower back. So he would press against the pain and I would be, hanging around like on a chair or something, so that he can push those pressure points. So it's important for you to do kind of a little bit of homework to find out what can help when I'm in pain, and when I have pain, what feels good. Some people like that touch, some hate it and don't want to be touched at all. So that's one thing. And myth number four is that labor, like delivery, could take up to 24 or 48 hours. Like sometimes you hear like, oh my God, she was in labor for like 28 hours, 36 hours. And a lot of women like scared, thinking, oh my gosh, she's been in pain this whole time. That must be horrible. Yes, it could take a long time. But from what I heard, a first delivery can take between 12 and 15 hours of labor. And when they say of labor, they mean from the first moment you had your first contraction pain. So the first contraction starts pretty much as a heavy menstruation cramps, or medium. And then it goes up and up and up. So they start counting from then. So most people, when they hear that number, think that, oh my God, they've been on the hospital, like in the hospital bed, pushing and screaming and in complete pain for like 24 hours. This is not what is happening, ladies. So yes, it is super painful, but no, it's not taking 24 hours of that pain. Otherwise you would die, literally. I hope this video was helpful. There's a lot more tips, but I don't want to make this video way too long. So what I would say again is that having a baby does not need to be in a hospital, in a whole clinical environment. Second, your water might not be the first thing that happens, that breaks. It might not happen at all. Pain medication is not a must for everyone, and there's ways to relieve pain. And what I say was the fourth one, I can't even remember. Mommy brain. Labor does not take 24 hours. When people say you're in pain for like 36 hours, whatever, 3 days, it does not mean that you're in pain for from minute one till that last minute. The pain actually builds up. So yes, it can be long, and that's why it's a marathon and not a sprint. You need to prepare for it. You need to have energy. You need to do your breathing exercises and everything that you can do in your power to help you feel comfortable and also help your baby to feel comfortable and ready to meet you. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.